A color organ is an electronic device that responded to the music input with light shows. In my case, the red light represents low frequency, blue light mid frequency and green light high frequency. You can find the Arduino program, schematics and a part list of example cellos in the description below. So let's get started with the parts. We're gonna need 3 bus 11 MOSFET, which have 3 pins from left to right, gate, drain and source. 1 200 kilo ohm resistor, which I didn't have, so I'm just gonna use 2 100 kilo ohm resistors in series. 2 100 nanofarad capacitors. 1 10 nanofarad capacitor. 1 33 picofarad capacitor. And as you can see, I tried using a 27 picofarad capacitor, which didn't work out. So get the right one right away and don't be as stupid as lazy as I am. An Arduino Uno development board, and I heard that people say they don't like using microcontrollers because it's too complicated. Well, here is the version of the color organ without a microcontroller. It's a tons of part, it's complicated, it takes too much time. You don't want to do that, so throw that away and use the microcontroller instead. 1 MSGEQ7 IC. 3 1 watt high power LEDs. I used Rebel Lux, which cost about 5 euro each, which is kind of expensive, but you can use those in the description below, they are much cheaper and also effective. But you can use any kind you want, it's your project, not mine. 3 power resistors, you can calculate the value of the resistors by yourself using the properties of the LED, or you can be lazy and just use 5 watts, about 5 ohm resistors. They should work just fine. 1 breadboard with a couple of jumper wires. 1 5 volt power supply, which can give you at least 1.5 amps to work with. 1 audio jack. And of course we're gonna need an awesome case for our color organ. I used those 3 bottles, they let the light shine through and the bottom side is concave so I can put my high power LED right under it, and there's a little hole where I can put my wire through, so it's perfectly for the project. Programming is for most people the boring part, but I already programmed it for you, so everything's good. Just have to open the sketch with the Arduino software and transfer it to your Arduino. Afterwards, you can use the schematics to wire up your Arduino. But for those who are interested in programming and want to know what's going on, I'll give you a quick explanation. Firstly, we have to define our pins, which is pretty standard. We're using 3 pins for the LEDs, 1 pin for the analog inputs, and 2 pins are very special, those are for the MSGEQ7, the reset pin and the strobe pin. And also we have an array for storing our variables, which are given by the MSGEQ7. In the setup, we say that all our pins are output, except for the analog pin, which is an input. And also, for the beginning, we put the reset pin low and the strobe pin high. In the loop, we are putting the reset pin high and then low. Now the MSGEQ7 is waiting for the change in the strobe pin to give us the first value. Afterwards, we are using a for loop, which we'll go through 7 times, because we get 7 values for 7 different frequency bands. That means we could use 7 LEDs, but I think 3 are enough. Firstly, we have to put the strobe pin low, then we wait for 30 milliseconds to let the value of the MSGEQ7 settle down. Then we store the value of the MSGEQ7 in the array which we defined earlier and let this value rescale so we can use this input later as an output. We use the constrain function and the map function for that. Afterwards, we are using the serial print function to let the value monitor on our serial monitor. You can see that later. And at the end, we are putting the strobe pin high again and go again through the for loop to get our 7 different values. Last but not least, we are using the analog write function to get the voltage to our gate of our MOSFETs to let the LED shine. For the last part, we have to wire up our solderless breadboard using this schematic. If you have absolutely no clue how to read a schematic and how to connect 2 points with wires, you can look it up on YouTube or on Google. The only difficult part that is mentionable is the audio jack, which has three pins. The left pin and the right pin are the different channels, and we only have to use one channel and connect that to the capacitor, which then goes into the MSGEQ7, and the pin in the middle is the ground, which goes to ground. The rest of the wiring should be pretty self-explanatory. I hope so, at least. And if you have questions, Google is your best friend. I guess that's it. Now you can use the serial monitor of the Arduino software to see the different voltage values of the 7 frequency bands. They should vary between 0 and 255 when your music is pumped up. And also you should see it on your LEDs whether they are working or not. Now you can expand the idea of the color organ by not only lighting up 3 high power LEDs, but using an RGB LED strip instead, and put that under your couch if you want to be really hardcore. If you liked that video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button, leave suggestions for the next electronic projects in the description below, and don't forget to subscribe, because there's gonna be a lot more videos like this in the future.